It's another Tuesday night edition of Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network.
I'm going to use the Ahmed term. It's a premature detonation.
I want to get the notch.
This is probably the most fired up I've ever been on the show, and I love it.
You're not just buying a racetrack. You're buying a piece of American racing history right there. I mean, that's huge. The history behind the track, just mind-boggling.
Race fans, it's time to throw it up on the cushion and get dirty. Live from the Casa de Pork Chop Studios, it's time for Turn 5 Live. Now, your hosts of Turn 5 Live, Stephen Ovens, Clint Miller, and Brad Ovens.
Special edition of Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Steve Ovens alongside with you here, getting ready to bring you the best of Turn 5 Live here on PMN. Got a special episode for you. Going to go over some of our favorite interviews from the past year as race season draws closer and moves away from 4th of July weekend. A lot of racetracks going over their mid-season championships this past weekend. And, of course, we'll start off things from the Black Rock Speedway as the Gin Boys swept the weekend at Black Rock on Friday night as Joe Gin picked up his first Black Rock Speedway feature win and then backed that up with a win in the regularly scheduled event. So let's get to the results. Joe Gin picked up the June 5th makeup feature event. 14 cars started that feature, 30 laps long. Gin got his first win of the season, and he had to beat out Steve Payne and Alan Johnson to do it. Payne came home second. Alan Johnson was third. Ron Cartwright Jr. was fourth. Cartwright Jr., of course, being the point leader going into the night's action by only 1 point over Payne. Payne would take over the points lead after the makeup feature. Donnie Lawson rounded out the top five. Tyler Seary was sixth. Seventh was Corey Costa, Derek Pozziadlo, Brady Foltz, and Stacy Jackson rounded out the top 10. Moving on to the regularly scheduled feature, again it was Gin who had to pass Tyler Seary and Steve Payne to get the lead. Payne would actually get back by Gin to take the lead, and Gin would get around him again to reclaim the lead and go on to take his second 30-lap feature win of the night. Payne would have to settle for second and extend his points lead. Tyler Seary, who needed a good run, has had some tough luck lately. Seary came home third, Corey Costa fourth, and Alan Johnson rounded out the top five. 6 or 10 was Donnie Lawson, Dale Welty, Chris Ostrowski, Marcus Dinkins, and Ron Cartwright Jr. Moving on to heat races won by Corey Costa and Tyler Seary. Moving on to the Crate Sportsman, picking up his first win at Black Rock, and I believe also his first Crate Sportsman feature win in his career. Jake Gin got the win, making it a Gin sweep for the night over Lauren Lincoln, Russell Morseman, Steve Gray, Casey Pavlik, and Jordan Seary. Casey Pavlik was the top five. Jordan Seary, Chris Fisher, Chris Silver, Stacy Jackson, and Doug Smith were your top 10 finishers. Heat races went to Chris Fisher, Jake Gin, and Lauren Lincoln. Moving on to the Morseman Racing Chassis Street Stocks, 18 cars were in attendance Friday night. 20-lap feature, Kurt Stebbins picked up his first win of the season. Of course, Stebbins defending Empire 100 champion at the Speedway. Defending Street Stock champion, Jeremy Petrobowski, who has been a fairly regular competitor the last couple weeks, came home second. Gene Ballmer third, Dennis Cummings fourth, and Laverne Knickerbocker was the top five. 6 or 10 was Ralph Champion, Jake Karlnoski, Teddy Morseman, CJ Guerry, and Chuck Winslow. Heat wins went to Kurt Stebbins, Gene Ballmer, and Laverne Knickerbocker. M&M Auto Sales and Service IMCA Modified 20-lap feature picked up his third win of the season and closes in on point leader Keith Lamphere. Jason Benjamin got the win. Nicole Spaulding, career best finish at Black Rock with a second place finish. Finished second over Logan Terry, Tony Harris, and Ken Buck. Scott Sebring, Sparky Hills, Keith Lamphere, Rodney Morgan, and Brad Smith rounded out the top 10. Rodney Morgan and Todd Stone picked up heat race wins. Napa Know-How 4-Cylinders, they also ran two feature events. In the June 5th makeup feature, 16 cars took the track for 20 laps, and James Kreidler picked up his fourth win of the season in the 79K. Rich Sharpstein extended his point lead with a second-place finish. Jeremy Trank finally got the 15K straightened back around and back to the track. He came home third, Scott Bradley fourth, Jason Smart the top five. Erica Bell, Chad Ayres, Dell Cummings, Zach Teed, and Desi Force were your top 10 for the June 5th makeup in the Napa Know-How Four Cylinders. Moving on to the regularly scheduled event, 25 cars took the green flag for 20 laps. Great field of four-cylinder cars. And 2001 track champion Joe Pavoski in the Rick Horton 4 car in a fill-in role picked up the victory over Rich Sharpstein, Jeremy Trank, who finished 2-3 for the second feature in a row. Wes Hotelling was 4th, Erica Bell the top 5. 6 through 10 was Brian Grant, Scott Bradley, who was in the Billy Bowers 14 car, Dell Cummings, Dan Smart, and David Wedham were your top 10 finishers. Erica Bell, James Kreidler, and Jeremy Trank rounded out your heat race winners. And in the Creekside Entertainment Bandit division, Jeff Doherty, out of Elmira, New York, picked up his 8th win of the season over Billy Bowers, Cheyenne LaBar, Pixie Kinner, Brandon Kinner, and Pollyanna Dean. So Doherty continues to dominate the division in the Bandit class. So that was your results from Friday night at the Black Rock Speedway. Great field of fans in attendance, great field of cars, outstanding fireworks display, as I'm sure many of you have seen on social media. If you haven't had a chance to check that out, you want to go ahead and do so. Moving on now to results from the Canandaigua Motorsports Park. Evening of Super Dirt Car Series from July 2nd, and Matt Shepard made a last lap pass to pick up the win over Larry White. Jimmy Phelps was third, Billy Decker fourth, and Stuart Friesen in the Mike Payne 7Z rounded out the top five. Peter Britton, Billy Dunn, Steve Payne, Rob Bellinger, and Justin Harris rounded out the top 10. In the Empire Super Sprints CNY Speed Week 25-lap A Main, it was the Cobra. No surprise there. Chuck Hebing picked up the win over Dylan Swernick. Stuart Friesen in Jessica's 1Z. Sean Donath and Steve Poirier were your top five. Brian Howland, Jason Barney, Matt Tanner, Justin Barger, and Danny Varin were your top 10 for the Empire Super Sprint. Safety Awareness Sportsman 20-lap feature there. James Michael Friesen picked up the win in what may be his first Canandaigua win over Dave Marcicelli, A.J. Lloyd, Nick Guerry, and Tyler Meeks. Carl Comfort, James Sweeting, Kane Bristol, Daryl Nutting, and Matt Guerry rounded out your top 10. They then moved on to Saturday night, July 4th, with a regular show there at Canandaigua. And again, picking up the win and picking up his 45th career big block modified feature win at Canandaigua was Matt Shepard, who picked up his 45th career win over Gary Tompkins, Justin Harris, Tim Fuller, and Mike O'Brien. Vic Coffey, Alan Johnson, Derek Pazziadlo, Chad Homan, and Dave Rauscher were your top 10 in the modified. Safety Awareness Sportsman Rob Bussey picked up the win over Andrew Smith, Nick Guerry, Carl Comfort, Eric Chiguer, Frank Guerry Jr., A.J. Lloyd, Paul Guerry, Ricky Newton, Matt Guerry were your top 10 there in the Sportsman Division. Dig Safely 305 Sprints, Darryl Ruggles picked up another win over Dan Bennett, David Ferguson, Lee Sanders, and Bob Dresty, the top five. Nick Cooper, Alicia Ruggles, Eric Carlson, Steve Dole, and Jonathan Preston were your top 10. In the Parts Plus Street Stock division, picked up his second win of the season and made a last lap pass on Mr. Smooth, Mark Minutlo. Steve Pizarik picked up the win over Minutlo, Mike Welch, Blaine Smith, and Pat Hobbs. Ron Greek, Pete Stefanski, Charles Harvey, and Tom Shoemaker rounded out the field. Street Stocks, Eric Chapman picked up yet another victory over Sean Lloyd, Brand Steinruck Jr., Chris Barnard, and Casey Wagner. Coming up Saturday, July 11th, full race program with Big Block Modifieds, Sportsman, 305 Sprints, Parts Plus Street Stocks, and Pure Stocks. Racing begins at 7 o'clock there at the Land of Legends. As you may have already seen, Woodhull Raceway lost, I believe, their third Saturday night in a row due to rain down there on the high banks. So thinking of all of our friends down at Woodhull, as they're having just a terrible time trying to get a show in, thanks in no part to Mother Nature. So hopefully the weather will turn back around for those guys here coming up this week. Looking at the schedule for the Black Rock Speedway coming up here on Friday night. Friday, July 10th will be a weekly racing program, including modified sportsmen, IMCAs, street stocks, four cylinders, and bandits. And all of that action will be presented by Gin Trucking. So after their huge win last weekend, they'll be presenting the racing action this Friday night. We've got a lot more to come. We're going to get into the best of Turn 5 Live with some of our favorite interviews over the course of the season so far this year. And we'll get to that right after this. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on PMN, the Performance Motorsports Network.
Max Dairy Bar is a proud supporter of Turn 5 Live and the Performance Motorsports Network. Opened in 1974, Max Dairy Bar has been a Penn Yan, Cayuga Lake, and Yates County staple, serving the best Hershey's hard ice cream. They also have soft serve ice cream, their weekly yogurt special, sorbet flavors, gluten-free options, frozen Greek yogurt, and non-dairy lemon ice. Don't forget about their tricky 18-hole putt-putt course that will test your skill to see if you have what it takes to be a champion. Max Dairy Bar and Mini Golf, located on State Route 14A, just south of the village of Penn Yan, right on the way to Black Rock Speedway on Friday nights. Visit them online at www.maxdairybar.com or Max Dairy Bar on Facebook and Twitter. Stop by Max Dairy Bar and tell them Turn 5 Live sent you.
We're growing like crazy and need account reps who know their way around agencies, the internet, and social media. Got connections? Or do you know how to get to the decision makers? Are you fearless? We need you. Internet radio, or as we call it, wireless mobile radio, is rapidly becoming the place to be with almost limitless income potential. So contact us to get involved with the fastest growing professionally produced group of internet radio stations in the world. Your imagination is the only limit here. Call 717-749-0444. That's 717-749-0444. Or you can email us at scorpionradiogroup@gmail.com. You want to ask for Sue.
Creekside Entertainment is the official DJ, photo booth, and uplighting company of Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network. Stuart Ovens and his staff at Creekside Entertainment are professional and experienced with events of any type. Creekside Entertainment specializes in wedding packages that are affordable and fun, and they are ready to serve you with the most up-to-date music and karaoke selection. If you can sing it in the shower, you can come out and sing it with Creekside Entertainment. And don't forget about the Creekside Entertainment photo booth and uplighting service that will transform your wedding or party into an event the family will be talking about for years. Trust the entertainment company that racers trust. Call Stu at area code 315-481-9700 or visit them online at creeksideentertainmentdj.com. You can also find them on Facebook and Twitter. Creekside Entertainment, division sponsor of the Black Rock Bandits in 2015.
Hi, race fans. This is Chris Macheski, and you're listening to Turn 5 on PMN.
Welcome back, race fans, to Turn 5 Live. You're listening to the best of Turn 5 Live, where we play some of our favorite interviews over the course of the 2015 season. And we're going to roll the clocks back a little bit to a guy who just picked up two feature wins over the weekend. Let's hear now from our interview with Joe Gin.
Welcome back, race fans, to Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Steve Ovens, Brad Ovens, joining you here on a Tuesday night. And now joining us on the hotline, driver of the Gin Trucking number 3, Joe Gin, joining the program. Joe, welcome aboard.
Hey, thanks for having me on.
Well, let's get it, right from the horse's mouth, as they say. You got some hot laps over at the Black Rock Speedway on Sunday. Talk to us about the laps that you guys were able to get and how things went for you.
Well, it's nice to finally get on the track this year, and I thought the track was in good condition for being during the day. The car worked real well for us, and we learned a few things that should help us throughout the year.
And going back to, you know, how 2014 went for you guys, give us a little bit of a, you know, rundown of where you guys raced, how things went for you guys. Yeah, I believe you guys were in the modified last year.
Yep, we done modified mostly at Woodhull last year. We had a up and down year. Coming in the last year, we had high expectations after winning the Lyle Sherwood race in 2013. And, we had some solid finishes. We ended the year real well at finishing fourth at the mod race at Black Rock with some tough competition, Steve Payne, Alan Johnson, and okay year.
Now, you talked about, you know, winning that Lyle Sherwood Memorial. I mean, of course, for the guys down at the Woodhull Raceway, that is a really, really big event. And as I understand it, that was actually your first win in the modified.
Yes, it was my first win. And it was a special race to win. And I'm glad to pick it up in that race.
And, you know, so now you guys... You move ahead to 2015. We saw you at the practice session on Sunday. Is Dundee Black Rock? Is that something that is going to be a part of your guys' weekly plans? Are you guys going to be hit or miss at Black Rock? How are things looking right now?
Right now, the plan is the 24th. We're gonna April. We're gonna start out at Black Rock and then run Woodhull the 25th and kind of see how things go. But we'd like to run Black Rock the whole year. We've had some real good runs over there, just had some tough luck, but really like the track over there and would like to run there full time this year.
And you talked about having that good run, you know, at the end of the year last year. You know, that certainly has got to give you guys a lot of confidence about, you know, we can come over here and run with the best of them, even when you probably haven't had a whole lot of experience at that track, you know, in previous years.
Oh, definitely. We've run there a few times, but with the modified not running there on a weekly basis, haven't had a lot of experience. We're glad that Mike Jackson brought him back for this year and would like to run there on a weekly basis.
What's the biggest learning curve that, you know, when you started running the modified, you know, what was the biggest thing that you had to adjust to or learn about driving these cars with all the power they have?
Toughest part was we started out in a four cylinder, so that was quite a big jump getting into a modified, but I guess so. Quite a bit of power difference there, but just adapting the track conditions, and we run over to Woodhull on a weekly basis, so that's a real tough competition. On any night, there's 12 to 15 drivers that could win, so it makes it tough.
Who were some of the guys, you know, early on in your modified career that, you know, you kind of pulled, you know, whether it was a word of encouragement or advice, or, you know, who were some of the drivers that that you were able to kind of lean on when you were first getting started in the modified?
Well, of course, with running Woodhull, Billy Van Pelt, you know, he's got a lot of wins over there, and he's a good guy and will help you with anything. So you try to get as much information as you can out of him, then you... So you got Donnie Lawson, who's run well over there, too. So guys like that, you try to get as much information as you can, learn from them.
I mean, those guys have so many laps there on the high banks at Woodhull. I mean, it's got to be, you know, when you first start out running with those guys, I mean, just the history and the laps that they have there, it's got to be a pretty unique experience for a younger guy like yourself, you know, moving up from the four cylinder ranks, the mini stocks, all the way up to the full blown modified. I mean, was that intimidating at all getting started, or was it just, you know, did you get that feeling that I'm one of the guys out here, you know, doing the same thing they are, trying to win?
It was a little intimidating, but we actually started off with some real good finishes. And, you know, when you run guys clean and they run you the same way, and you earn their respect real fast. So that helps out a lot.
Talk to us about the draw-redraw format that Woodhull runs. I feel like in the off season, you know, whether it was on the air or off the air, I've talked to a lot of guys, and I honestly can't really seem to gauge where the drivers sit on that draw format. Tell us, you know, kind of where you guys sit on, you know, do you like the system? Do you prefer handicapping? Does it not matter? Where do you sit on that?
Honestly, for me, I can't draw very good, so the draw-redraw system doesn't work that good. But, it's definitely nice to, you know, if you qualify for a redraw position, to start up near the front of the field. It doesn't really matter. If you got a good car and you know you can get through traffic, you're confident in what you can do, so it doesn't really matter a whole lot. But like if you're an out-of-towner, it's kind of nice to have the opportunity to start towards the front.
That's very true. Looking at, you know, the practice session that you guys had on Sunday, I mean, I know that was during the daytime, and the Friday night races will be, you know, run at night under the lights, and you know, track conditions certainly will be different that way. But based on the good run you had last year and then the practice that you had on Sunday, did you guys feel that you're kind of picking right up where you left off, or is there still some things that you guys are going to need to continue to work on to keep having those good finishes?
We actually had our Woodhull car, or the car we plan on running at Woodhull there Sunday, and run real good with that. And we think that our car we plan on running there on Friday nights is actually a little bit better, and that's the one we run at the end of the year. So we feel pretty good about our chances. And I know Mike plans on running us last on a nightly basis. So the track conditions shouldn't be too far off from what they were on practice on Sunday. So we're really confident where we're at, and we think we'll be in real good shape once the season starts.
And you talked about, the two cars. What are you guys running for chassis, and then what do you have strapped between the frame rails there?
We have TO chassis, and they're both small blocks that built by Campbell Engines out of Dansville. He makes a real good power plant, and we're confident in what we have.
Now, we've talked to some guys, and I've actually had a few conversations off the air with some of the modified guys. Based on the fact that you guys are going to be running last on the nightly card, do you think that plays into the hands of the guys that are going to run the small block there?
I think it plays a little part. Small blocks are at a little bit of a disadvantage on a heavy track early on in the evening, but if you look at the races that have been run there the last few years with the small blocks and big blocks, I think the small blocks have won majority of the time, so it should be definitely competitive.
I think you're right, and we've even talked to some guys that, you know, have tried to go out and make both, you know, big and small block available, you know, depending on how things go. You know, they may change from one to the other. But Joe, appreciate the time getting to catch up with you here and kind of talk about, you know, what you guys are looking forward to this season. Give us a little rundown on all the folks that support the three car and help you get out onto the track each week.
I definitely couldn't do it without my family. They're big supporters. My girlfriend Kara, TMT Gravel and Contracting, HP Smith and Son Insurance, Cameron Mills Market, K&A Auto, K Camp Bell Engines, and everybody that helps us out. Pete and Patty, couldn't do it without them.
Are you guys all set with practice now, or are we going to see you again on Sunday?
Oh, it's possible we might be there on Sunday. We're in the process of putting our other car together, so we'll see how that works out, and we could be there.
All right, man. Well, appreciate the time tonight, and hopefully we'll see you on Sunday, and if not, definitely on opening night.
Okay, looking forward to it. Thanks, guys.
All right, that's Joe Jin, driver of the Jin Trucking number 3. You'll possibly see him again on Sunday afternoon, but for sure, opening night, Friday, April 24th. We're going to have more here on Turn 5 Live, including more dirt track discussion, and we've got Greg Hickson coming up at 8:15. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on PMN, the Performance Motorsports Network.
You hear that? That's the sound of America's only sports car. That's right, it's a Corvette. But not just any Corvette, it's your Corvette. It's that who cares if there's traffic part of your day. And this could be you when you come to Cooper Corvettes. With 60 years of Corvettes to choose from, there's always a Corvette in your budget. And they'll service any Corvette you bring in. Cooper Corvettes, on Route 1 just north of Quantico in Triangle. Call, click, or visit CooperCorvettes.com.
Hi, this is Yen Scott from Summit Point Kart in Summit Point, West Virginia. If you're looking for a real racing experience on a real racetrack, come out to Summit Point Kart this weekend. For as little as $25, you can get your racing career started. New this year, Summit Point Kart offers the RX250 capable of over 75 miles an hour. We're open every Friday from 5 p.m. till 9 p.m., Saturday from noon till 10 p.m., and Sunday from noon till 9 p.m. For more information, go to our website, summitpointkartwithak.com, or you can call us at 304-725-5270. Summit Point Kart, your East Coast Karting Center.
In the race of everyday life, it's nice to have the green flag, but drivetrain problems are the pits. A fully remanufactured engine, transmission, or differential from Jasper Engines and Transmissions costs less than a new vehicle and comes with a 3-year, 100,000-mile nationwide transferable warranty. See JasperEngines.com for details and get the green flag in your race of everyday life.
See the boys at Chandler & Sons Automotive, 45977 Old Ox Road in Sterling. Give them a call, 703-437-7300.
Creekside Entertainment is the official DJ, photo booth, and uplighting company of Turn 5 Live and the Performance Motorsports Network. Stuart Ovens and his staff at Creekside Entertainment are professional and experienced with events of any type. Creekside Entertainment specializes in wedding packages that are affordable and fun, and they are ready to serve you with the most up-to-date music and karaoke selection. If you can sing it in the shower, you can come out and sing it with Creekside Entertainment. And don't forget about the Creekside Entertainment photo booth and uplighting service that will transform your wedding or party into an event the family will be talking about for years. Trust the entertainment company that racers trust. Call Stu at area code 315-481-9700 or visit them online at CreeksideEntertainmentDJ.com. You can also find them on Facebook and Twitter. Creekside Entertainment, division sponsor of the Black Rock Bandits in 2015.
Hi, race fans. This is Fran Hilton, and you're listening to Turn 5 Live on PMN.
Welcome back, race fans, to the best of Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Next up, we're going to go to an interview we did talking about the Upstate Sportsman Alliance, which just ran a race this past weekend at the Weedsport Speedway. We got to do so with one of the ringleaders of the USA, Corey Reed. Let's now hear from Corey.
Now we're going to go over to the hotline and bring in Corey Reed from the Upstate Sportsman Alliance. Of course, Corey's been around dirt track racing for as long as anybody in the business. If you know anything about dirt track racing here in Central New York, you know the name Corey Reed. Also part of the Fulton Speedway and Brewerton Speedway. Corey, great to talk to you tonight here on Turn 5 Live. Let's talk about the Upstate Sportsman Alliance.
Sure. Real excited to finally get the word out on what we're doing. We're pretty excited. We're finally ready to launch it, and can't wait to get the thing rolling.
Well, let's start right from the beginning, Corey. How did all of this come about? And I mean,
lately, it seems like unless the tracks, you know, are owned by the same owner or promoted by the same person, you don't typically see in our area tracks working together like this, but this is a really unique program.
Well, that's exactly, you hit the nail on the head. I mean, there's not enough of tracks working together, and especially in our situation where there is a whole lot of tracks all pretty close together, relatively close together compared to a lot of parts of the world, all running relatively similar programming, and this, I think, is probably a start of potentially more working relationship down the road. Specifically the sportsman, it's such a, at this point, it's very untapped as far as, I mean, it's undoubtedly the fastest growing type of class and really all of motorsports that I can see, or at least around here, definitely, and we needed to take it. You know, I looked at all these tracks, you know, as I think we said in our release, I visualized all these tracks and all these races, you know, and but it didn't really add up to anything. You know, it was cool that we all had the Outlaw Weekend, and Jimmy's going to have the Crate Sportsman Classic 2, and Jeremy's got the Cabin Fever, and Bill's got the stuff. So, I mean, we had all the different races on the landscape, but nothing really linking them together. And I said, you know, that's a great way for us to get together, work together, to try to, you know, hey, it gives the racers a little something extra to shoot for, but also hopefully on our front, it increases our car count and just it provides a little bit more build up, a little more excitement in each of those events.
And as far as the USA, I mean, you guys have come out this weekend and tried to make it clear for everybody that, you know, this is not another traveling series. I mean, your guys' events, as far as the, you know, the 10 quote-unquote tour races go, I mean, these are all events that take place on normally scheduled competition for each of these tracks.
For the most part, yes. That's what we looked at, was how do we link the already existing events? I don't want to create a series. I don't want to create a tour that's extensive in travel. I don't want to create something that's undoable for the guys. I mean, it's already going to be challenging enough, but it's, you know, because of the number of events we want you to do with our home track, you know, the weekly track events that we're requiring. But honestly, that's what the backbone of what we do is anyway. I mean, if it isn't for the Saturday and Sunday and Friday night tracks, you know, it's hard for racing to exist. I mean, we need to have competitors there on a weekly basis, and that's really the reason for that element of the program. But, you know, we didn't, back to the other deal, we didn't really want to make it a series. We didn't really want to, I mean, you got dirt series, you got grit series, you got different things, and, you know, we don't need to be just another one competing against all them. That's not really what this is about. And we're going to be very loose on our rules. You know, it's really an alliance. It'll be home track rules on particular events from a format perspective right down the line. We're not coming in and trying to tell tracks how to run things or any of that stuff. It's just hopefully it's a, you know, the good news is we all pretty much think the same way. You know, all five tracks, the operators are all pretty much on the same page with everything, and that's going to make life easy for this deal.
Now, talk to us about, you know, how this is all structured. You know, I understand that, you know, the sportsman racers that are going to attend these events, you know, there's not only the structure for the 10 events at all of the five different tracks, but there's also, you know, kind of a home track portion of this as well.
We didn't really want to limit to a true home track, like say the Dirt Series. However, we wanted to create as much moving around as possible amongst the cars. So we went with our best 15 finishes in the region from basically the start of the year to Labor Day, basically like a home track bonus point situation would be, except without them being bonus points. They're actually your best 15 finishes. If it's 15 wins, that's 900 points. And you would add those 900 points to whatever points you earn on the championship tour events. Which, you know, that they're all like 100 points, they're all a little bit bigger in scope. But we really didn't want to, no disrespect to some of the travelers out there and the guys that come out and guys and girls that race from elsewhere, but this is about our teams that are local. This is about our Fulton, Burton, Canandaigua, Weed Sport, Utica, Rome teams. That's who we're catering to here, and we want this to really benefit them, and that's why we really want it to be focus on the weekly and then link the big events into it. And that's really what the whole thing is all about.
Talk to us about, you know, as far as the points or the you know, the point structure or the you know, the payment structure. It sounds like, you know, this could be a really, really good deal for the top 10 teams.
Yeah, I mean, we're not going in there promising, you know, getting rich off of this deal. I mean, we want to provide a reward at the end to encourage teams to participate and encourage teams and reward teams that do well. We went with $1,000 base for each of the top 10. We felt that that was kind of a different mentality, different format. And thanks to the Capreras, we're able to raise that money, and it's already you know, in house. And so there's, you know, a $10,000 point fund to start going into the thing. But we really wanted to make it about participation. This just rewards those 10 that do. And ultimately, when it's all said and done, that's probably what you'll see that end up doing everything. You know, there'll be lots and lots of teams that start the year or intend to do the whole thing, but ultimately, the 10 that gut it out are usually usually it's about 10 people when it's all said and done. So that's sort of the methodology behind the 10. We'll also add some, we're hoping to add some more elements, be some more bonus prizes, and perhaps pay deeper down the line as well once we get rolling here. But, you know, our commitment at this point was the top 10, and we felt that, you know, like I said, fortunate that the Capreras stepped up and helping us, and we're able to get that money and have it ready for the team.
How difficult is it to take five tracks that, you know, certainly Fulton and Brewerton are, you know, your Friday, Saturday. I mean, they're both owned by the White family. But how difficult is it to get these other three tracks on board, working in the same direction when, you know, this is kind of uncharted territory?
It was actually surprisingly easy. Like I said, I think in this particular case, every single one of us that were involved, the promoters that are involved in this, identify the fact that the sportsmen are a huge part of our weekly event, huge part of what we have to do, and we haven't done a very good job of it. I mean, everybody's been all over the place. You know, there's various rules packages around, you know, surrounding, you know, this region versus another region, and I'm not saying any one particular rules package is right. It's just, we need to all stay together, and they know that. Jimmy knows it. Jeremy knows it. Bill knows it, and of course we know it. And so it made it really easy. Actually, this was a phone call. I mean, ultimately, to be honest with you, it's probably taken a lot longer to do it than it should have. Because really, once we got it rolling, it only, you know, once we all kind of, we did it over text messages. All we did, you know, emails and text messages, and it was done. And you know, it's just, it's a pretty easy concept, really, just linking everything together. It's not hard to do. So, and these guys all agree with it and all identify that it's a great opportunity and good for the teams and good for us.
What so far has been the reaction? I imagine it's been a lot of positivity so far.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I hinted to some folks earlier this winter we're going to do something like this. I know Jeremy had hinted it on his track Facebook page back in November, and there was a lot of comments then, and then a lot of people got back with me and said, what are you going to do with this? When's this going to happen? And at the time, we were sort of in the middle of the planning process, and we weren't really, really committed at that point. And then, like I said, now that we've announced that you know, our Facebook page which is where our primary source of information will be, you know, that's pretty much exploded. I mean, we 600 plus followers in just a few days, so we're pretty excited. I think that there's enough teams out there that I think that it'll give them something to be excited about without having to travel. I mean, again, if you're even coming from the farthest reaches, let's say a Watertown car or a Utica car, I mean, it's really 2 hours to the furthest destination. So, for the most part, so maybe two and a half at the most. So you know, we think we've created something that will be doable, gives them a reason to go to some of the extra events, and hopefully just gives them some fun. We, you know, we want to build some other elements into it. The tracks, we've all kind of talked, and, you know, we want to kind of create maybe to the point of a team, you know, Team Canandaigua versus Team Bolton. You know, have some fun with it. Let the teams take some pride in where they come from, you know, representing, you know, the very whatever their various track is they represent, and just create some rivalry, create some fun. And, you know, a lot of it I see on social media, and a little bit of the gamesmanship that goes on between tracks with some of the guys and girls that run at the various tracks. You see the little jabs and whatever, and I think as a whole, the sportsman bunch is a really good-natured bunch, and I think that's what will make this a lot more fun.
Absolutely. What will be the first championship event that we'll see on the schedule?
The first one is at Canandaigua, the Cabin Fever 64, that Jeremy and Nick Carreri is really, really active in. And so that'll be our first show. Then we'll come back. I believe the second one is at Utica Rome. And effectively, we go through the whole list of tracks and then go back to each track again. So each track gets two. We'll have two at each track. You know, all spaced out from April to October, so it should be pretty easily doable for the team.
Well, that's great. You know, Corey, we appreciate your time talking to us about this. Again, Upstate Sportsman Alliance on Facebook for all of the late-breaking information coming from the USA. Wish you guys a lot of luck. I think this is really a movement toward the future, you know, as far as dirt track racing and tracks and teams and drivers working together to create something positive here. And you know, wish you guys a lot of luck, and we'll see you guys at the Cabin Fever event.
That sounds good. Sure appreciate you having me on.
All right, that's Corey Reed from the Upstate Sportsman Alliance. We're going to go to a quick break here on the other side. More dirt track discussion. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network.
How would you like to win a brand new Corvette? Larry O's got all the details.
WinYourNewCar.com. Enter America's number one dream car giveaway contest at WinYourNewCar.com. Complete the puzzle the fastest and win a new Corvette tax-free. Come on, stop dreaming. Start driving with WinYourNewCar.com.
You hear that? That's the sound of America's only sports car. That's right. It's a Corvette. But not just any Corvette. It's your Corvette. It's that who cares if there's traffic part of your day. And this could be you when you come to Cooper Corvettes. With 60 years of Corvettes to choose from, there's always a Corvette in your budget. And they'll service any Corvette you bring in. Cooper Corvettes on Route 1 just north of Quantico and Triangle. Call, click, or visit CooperCorvettes.com.
Hi, this is Yen Scott from Summit Point Kart in Summit Point, West Virginia. If you're looking for a real racing experience on a real racetrack, come out to Summit Point Kart this weekend. For as little as $25, you can get your racing career started. New this year, Summit Point Kart offers the RX250 capable of over 75 miles an hour. We're open every Friday from 5 p.m. till 9 p.m., Saturday from noon till 10 p.m., and Sunday from noon till 9 p.m. For more information, go to our website, summitpointkartwithak.com, or you can call us at 304-725-5270. Summit Point Kart, your East Coast karting center.
In the race of everyday life, it's nice to have the green flag, but drivetrain problems are the pits. A fully remanufactured engine, transmission, or differential from Jasper Engines and Transmissions costs less than a new vehicle and comes with a 3-year, 100,000-mile nationwide transferable warranty. See JasperEngines.com for details and get the green flag in your race of everyday life.
See the boys at Chandler & Sons Automotive, 45977 Old Ox Road in Sterling. Give them a call, 703-437-7300.
If you're a gearhead, you probably go online to those hot rod superstores, drooling over the chrome and speed goodies until you find just the right item for your muscle car, tuner car, truck. But what do you do when it comes to fixing the mom-mobile? If you're like most do-it-yourselfers, you head to the strip-mall part store and talk to the "Do you want fries with that?" kid behind the counter. Hold on, Bunky! Did you stop to think where those chain stores are getting the parts that you're installing in the vehicle that's used to transport your family everywhere? They get the cheapest suppliers they can find to sell you the parts at bargain prices. Their limited lifetime warranties? What a joke! Remember the last time mom's car broke down? You heard about that one for weeks. Don't take that chance again. Excelsior Racing has the quality parts you need for your family vehicle. Parts that you can install knowing you're getting the best for your family. Excelsior Racing. Quality parts, personalized service, affordable pricing, fast to you direct. Excelsior Racing. Online at ExcelsiorRacing.com or call 502-909-2034.
Hi, race fans. This is Mel Thomas from Thomas Video, and you're listening to Turn 5 Live on PMN.
Welcome back, race fans, to Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Clint Miller, Steve Ovens joining you here, and now we're going off to the hotline to bring in modified driver, local competitor, out of Peñon, New York, Derek Pozziadlo. Derek, welcome to the show. Good to have you here on Turn 5 Live.
Well, thanks for having me, boys. Appreciate the call.
Absolutely. Man, let's start from the beginning here, because I know a lot of the local folks, you know, in the Peñon, Dundee, Canandaigua area have gotten to know you over the years, but I want to kind of start from the beginning. How exactly did you get into this racing business?
Well, you know, it kind of started out as, you know, a spectator going to back in the Dundee Speedway, back when Steve Wetmore was running the show, and Lynn Huffin just getting the itch right there with my dad of doing something, getting out there, and, you know, basically started when I was young, just got into my blood, and that was here we are today.
And today is including running the big block modified there at Canandaigua. You guys have really made that your home, you know, since you guys have kind of been in this deal. You know, talk to us about running at Canandaigua. What's it's always a challenge there. The field there at Canandaigua is just so competitive.
It has been. You know, when the 358s left Blackrock, and we were over to Canandaigua and decided to run with the big blocks. It was pretty much, you know, the only places close by to go. You know, we were in there with the likes of, you know, Tim McCready, Bob McCready, Alan and Danny, and it was, you know, me going from a boy sitting in the grandstands to out there running with these icons, and building, you know, racing relationships with these people were, you know, an unbelievable experience, one. And it still is an unbelievable experience every time, you know, you pull into the gate over there at Canandaigua, because, you know, it's called the Land of Legends for a reason. You know, there are legends there, you know, 10 years ago when we first started going over there, and still today. You know, people like, you know, Tim Fuller coming back this year. You know, Paul Johnson boys running there. You know, Steve Payne, who's a, you know, who's won everything between here, you know, Dundee and Canandaigua. I enjoy it. It's extremely, extremely difficult to be successful over there, but it's fun. We have a good time, and, you know, I wouldn't want to be anywhere else.
What's the most difficult part about trying to get a hold of the track there? I mean, Jeremy really puts a lot of time and effort into the racing surface, and you know, it tends to show.
Yeah, Jeremy does a great job. He, you know, we knew when he took over that deal that the track was going to be phenomenal. Every week it is. You know, this year I think is even a little bit better than last year. A couple different grooves and stuff. You know, the biggest thing over there is you're running with the best of the best. You know, if you get lucky enough to have a good night, you know, you pat yourself on the back, and so doesn't everybody else. You know, it's really hard to explain. You know, you run, say you have a top 10, you know, you feel good. But, you know, us that run over there, you know, weekly, like myself, Chad Holman, you know, those guys, when we have a good run, you know, we compliment each other. You know, we might be in the top 10. People might see, oh, you're only 9th or 10th, but there's 15 guys over there that are could win at any night.
You and I have talked quite a bit, Derek, and explain to the folks what it was like going from racing two nights a week from Canandaigua, and then you guys would go to Weed Sport Sunday when it was open all the time. Explain to the people that are listening what it was like, you know, having to scale back to a weekly program, and if that helped or hurt your quest.
You know, it was at the time when we were doing Saturday and Sunday. It felt like a lot. You spend a lot of time at the shop. You know, you spend a lot of time traveling back and forth and racing. But once we went back to, you know, Weed Sport closed up, we were only running Canandaigua one night. You know, you realize you're putting in the same amount of work at the shop, and you're getting half the results. You really didn't realize it for a couple of years, but it really hurt my program, just with seat time, you know, having that feel, you know, talking to people, reading the tracks, you know, going with your gut instinct on setups. It really hurt, and it kind of, you know, I won't lie, it got discouraging the last couple of years. Just, you know, you're running against guys that run four nights a week, three nights a week, and you're there on a Saturday night. You know, you worked all week long. You know, you're tired, and you get in there to have fun and just relax, and these guys are driving by like you're standing still some nights, and you're like, man, I put the hours in at the shop. You know, my stuff is good. You know, everything's set, not having mechanical failures, but you're still, you know, you're still at that 10th to 15th where you feel like you should be up in the top 10. It's hard. You know, you have to put in perspective, you know, we're not full-time racers. You know, we work Monday through Friday, really Sunday through Sunday anymore. But you know, you kind of take that back, but your competitiveness wants to run with those guys, and it doesn't matter, you know, whose name's on it. It's another car in front of you that you want to beat. You know, it might be Matt Shepard, Danny Johnson, Alan Johnson in front of you, that they're stiff competition, but it's still a car that you want to race with and be competitive with. And it's really hurt. I got a breath of fresh air this year, running just those few shows at Blackrock. Then that definitely helped boost confidence. You know, made you a little, you know, just give you that little bit more of an edge. And it really made you realize how much not running two nights a week hurts a program like ours, where you have to be on top of your game to compete with these guys at the level that we're at.
Well, Derek, I think naturally that would lead me to my next question is, you know, what are the chances that we see you on a regular basis on a Friday night?
I'm in big favor of this. And my fingers have been crossed ever since, you know, they started running big black, small blacks again, that hopefully, you know, one of these years, this was going to happen. And, you know, I give Mike and Sue all the credit in the world for going out and trying to do this and making this happen. For me personally, I can't wait. I know it's going to, you know, bring my confidence back a little bit, you know, bring, you know, just get back into the groove. And I'm excited. You'll definitely see me Friday nights over there and Saturday nights at Canandaigua.
Well, I know that you guys have got to be confident about making a return to Dundee, because, Derek, let's face it, you guys were on it in those midweek, or not midweek, but the special modified shows they had at Yates County in 2014. I mean, you guys were competitive. Matter of fact, the night that you started up front, I mean, those guys were having a hard time catching up to you. So, I mean, that's got to make you feel good, you know, headed back to a schedule there.
It does. Like I said, you know, just that confidence booster is of, you know, going forward, you know, having good feel of a race car, you know, finishing up front. You know, I don't think we legitimately weren't outside the top five. You know, we're leading that race, got two flat tires in that feature. You know, that's what are you going to do? You know, we were, it was that 60 lapper, I think we started 15th and drove up to 5th with no cautions, and still going forward at the end of the race. I'm super excited. We're tickled that we're going to go back and be able to run competitively. I mean, you know, don't get me wrong. There's going to be a group of guys over there that are going to be battling hard for the win every night. Good guys. Everybody that I think we all have almost respect for, and I really think you're going to see some great racing over there this year.
I couldn't agree with you more there, Derek. I think the racing is going to be phenomenal. In order for you to be racing there on Fridays and Canandaigua on Saturdays, I know it takes a heck of a crew and some sponsors on board with you, and want to give you a chance to talk about those folks.
Yeah, no, it definitely is. You know, I have great people involved helping me, you know, at the shop. You know, Jason Hassels has been with me forever, wrenching on the cars, and you know, he's seen how it helps as far as setup wise, driving, making decisions. Jody Stelz helped me out last year. He's going to help me out again this year. You know, I have Andrew Jensen helping me, you know, and other people that come and go and help and are there. And, you know, most of the words of encouragement, you know, just the support that every time that we'd go down there to race, you know, there'd be 10, 20 people from town that, you know, that come because they know that we're there. And that's encouraging. You know, people are interested. There's a lot of interest, and that's going to help. You know, it's going to help my sponsors, Penny Express Stop, Penny and Mini Storage, Tom Pontello, CPA. It'll help all these sponsors in town, the businesses, get their name back out there, get people back involved. It won't take much. The people in town have been talking about going there with a headline division for a long time, and I'm excited.
Well, we're looking forward to seeing you over there, Derek, without a doubt. Want to thank you for your time joining us on the show, and man, it won't be too much longer. We'll be seeing you over there at the Speedway.
Absolutely. Hopefully we'll be talking to you again. Hopefully from Victor Lane we'll be talking to you, and hopefully that's real soon.
Yeah, awesome. Absolutely. Well, there's Derek Potsiadlo, driver of the Penny and Express Stop 21. Right after this, Clint will break down everything that Derek just told us about, and very shortly we'll have Dean Reynolds coming on from the Lucas Oil Empire Super Sprints. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network.
Max Dairy Bar is a proud supporter of Turn 5 Live and the Performance Motorsports Network. Opened in 1974, Max Dairy Bar has been a Penn Yan, Cayuga Lake, and Yates County staple, serving the best Hershey's hard ice cream. They also have soft serve ice cream, their weekly yogurt special, sorbet flavors, gluten-free options, frozen Greek yogurt, and non-dairy lemon ice. Don't forget about their tricky 18-hole putt-putt course that will test your skill to see if you have what it takes to be a champion. Max Dairy Bar and Mini Golf, located on State Route 14A, just south of the village of Penn Yan, right on the way to Black Rock Speedway on Friday nights. Visit them online at www.maxdairybar.com or Max Dairy Bar on Facebook and Twitter. Stop by Max Dairy Bar and tell them Turn 5 Live sent you. Creekside Entertainment is the official DJ, photo booth, and uplighting company of Turn 5 Live and the Performance Motorsports Network. Stuart Ovens and his staff at Creekside Entertainment are professional and experienced with events of any type. Creekside Entertainment specializes in wedding packages that are affordable and fun, and they are ready to serve you with the most up-to-date music and karaoke selection. If you can sing it in the shower, you can come out and sing it with Creekside Entertainment. And don't forget about the Creekside Entertainment photo booth and uplighting service that will transform your wedding or party into an event the family will be talking about for years. Trust the entertainment company that racers trust. Call Stu at area code 315-481-9700 or visit them online at creeksideentertainmentdj.com. You can also find them on Facebook and Twitter. Creekside Entertainment, division sponsor of the Black Rock Bandits in 2015.
We're growing like crazy and need account reps who know their way around agencies the internet, and social media. Got connections? Or do you know how to get to the decision makers? Are you fearless? We need you. Internet radio, or as we call it, wireless mobile radio, is rapidly becoming the place to be with almost limitless income potential. So contact us to get involved with the fastest growing professionally produced group of internet radio stations in the world. Your imagination is the only limit here. Call 717-749-0444. That's 717-749-0444. Or you can email us at scorpionradiogroup@gmail.com. You want to ask for Sue.
Hi, Rays fans. This is Mark Manulo, and you're listening to Turn 5 Live on PMN.
Welcome back to the best of Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Steve Ovens hosting our best of episode, getting ready to play four fan favorite interviews, one with Gary Tompkins from the Guerri Racing Party, one with Ray Hendershot, also from the Guerri Racing Party. We caught up with Daryl Ruggles early on in the 2015 season, and we caught up with Kelly Hebing at the Motorsports Expo. All fan favorite interviews. And they will fill out the second hour tonight of Turn 5 Live. So let's hear now from Gary Tompkins.
Welcome back, race fans, to Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Steve Ovens coming to you from the Guerri Racing Back Row Gang Benefit Party here in Seneca Falls, New York. Now we're going to get to catch up with Big Block Modified driver Gary Tompkins. Haven't had you on the show in quite some time. No. Good to have you here.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.
Let's talk about 2014. How do we evaluate last season as we get ready to start 2015?
It started out like gangbusters. We won the Janmore Corcoran Memorial. Beginning of the year, we were really good, especially at Canandaigua. We were as good as anybody, and we ended up blowing up our really good motor, and everything went downhill from there. You really got to be on the ball on these things. And, the motor we had running after that wasn't quite up to par. We were giving up a little bit anyway, but then we gave up more. And then just after that, it was just, stupid stuff happening to us and mechanical breakdowns and stuff. We go to Syracuse and we were mid-pack, which we knew we were going to be because the track was fast. We went up there with a deal like we always do, is we want to finish the race. Well, I made two laps, burnt a bunch of pistons. Still haven't figured out why. I almost think maybe got some bad gas or something. I don't know. We went to Brockville the following week, and we ran decent there, but the track rubbered up, and we didn't finish as well as we were running. We finished 11th, but we were probably, a top five car. Go to Eastern States, drive a 673 there. And again, qualified not really good. We took a little bit to get the car going, but we were fast. Had to run through the consies on Sunday, but we were fast and make two laps there, break a jack shaft and rear end. Holy cow, I've never done that before.
Yeah.
Get everything back together, go to Charlotte, and we just had a bad weekend there, and had one DNF and then one we ended up hurting the motor. So it just, end of the year was terrible for us, and the way you end the year sometimes carries over, and it's just tough to get going this year, finding help and stuff like that to get going for this year.
Yeah. So is that kind of where we're at right now for
15? Well, right now we're working on our motor program, trying to figure out what's going on there, trying to get the motor fixed and come up with funds to get it fixed. And, the car, I tried selling the frame, and there's so many cars out there that are in decent shape that they basically given away and I wasn't going to give it my car away. It's really in good shape. So I think we're just going to put that back together and then see what we can do about finding something to power it and go from there. If we can come up with a motor program, it's decent, I think we should be okay. But that's going to be the problem right now. And hopefully we can find something, it's going to be good because this deal, they pull this deal off at Rolling Wheels like they say they're going to. Yeah, we run really well at that place for whatever reason.
Sure.
And there's definitely some money to be made there. So, hopefully we can figure something out there and get on the track and do some running at that place.
Now, as far as rolling wheels goes, I mean, what your sentiments are, it seems to be what I hear from everybody about that deal.
Yep.
Is, you know, speaking as a veteran driver, you know, are we going to get to opening night there before we really know what's going on? Or
I don't think it'd be opening night, but I think it's going to be pretty close to that for sure. You know, I'm sure there's going to be that car show up in Syracuse. I would think they're going to have a presence there. You know, they would be smart to just
sure.
to get the news out. You know, and more, you know, they've been having a presence on Facebook, but that's, you know, they're playing games with that. You know, it's not really telling us, the racers, you know, what's going to go on there. You know, how's, you know, we don't even know, you know, how many laps the events are and stuff like that, or the schedule, you know, the race schedule for each night, you know, how everything goes. So, you know, how qualifying goes and stuff like that. So, you know, it's just one of them wait and see deals. It's still got a little bit of time, you know.
Yeah.
You know, they have a schedule out there, but there's, you know, they say they're going to have a series race, but then they're, right now, they got to have a series, they got to race up against the series race at Canandaigua. So it's like,
right.
But you can't do that, you know,
right.
So you got to figure out something. But, you know, hopefully, you know, they pull it off because, you know, I really want to see that place thrive. I think it's a great track. I think it's, if it's done right, I you know, I give credit to Dirt. They really tried to make it go of it, but I don't think they ran there enough. And, you know, they needed to spend some money on it. And hopefully this deal here will spend some money on the place.
Yeah.
Not only, you know, they need upgrades around the facility, you know, and stuff like that, but I hope they fix the track to it. It needs a, you know, and we've all known this, needs a new surface, you know, and some stuff fixed there. So hopefully it comes up, you know, but it's one of the deals, it sounds really good. So
right, right.
I've been around long enough to know usually when it sounds really good, it's not, you know. So hopefully this is.
Yeah.
You know, we'll see what happens, but they say they're full steam ahead, so hopefully they are.
You talked about the surface there. It's been a while since it's had a resurface.
Yeah, it's been quite a few years, and, you know, especially, you know, you can't really see it from the stands or anything, but down at the other end, turn three and stuff like that, it's getting down to bare rocks and spots, and,
okay.
You know, it's just getting to be where, you know, it's getting to be where it's not as raceable as it used to be. But the problem is, when they did put, I don't know who put the surface on it before, whatever surface they use, the material they use, is, had sand in it or something. That's why it's always dusty. It's nothing, you know, you can't water sand and not have it be dusty.
Right.
You know, and so they need to find some good material, and hopefully if they do, and because I've been there when that place is good, and boy, it's fun to race at, you know, but it's not fun when it's dusty and you can't see, and you're going as fast as you go at that place, because you really go fast at that place.
Absolutely. You talk about, you know, the material for a track. Did you get a chance to get on the new surface at Weedsport?
I did not. I have not. I know, talking to some guys, you know, obviously it looks different, you know, because it's sort of reddish clay, which is sort of not usual for this area. But just talking to people, you know, it sounded like it was pretty slippery and stuff like that. But I think, you know, you put it on in the middle of the year and really, you know, you got to run it on a few times. So hopefully letting it sit and, you know, they're going to have some shows on there. I think they'll get it figured out, because that's one thing I know about Al Hanke is he really wants to make that thing go. So I think they're going to do whatever it takes to be successful there. I'm really thrilled for that. You know, I sort of grew up at that place. When Glenn first bought the track, my mom and dad worked for him. My dad ran the caution lights, and my mom worked concession stands. So I ran all over that place down there when I was a little kid. So I spent a lot of Sunday afternoons and Sunday nights there. So I really like to see that place, you know, go and be a success.
Wow. Now that's a little bit of history I wasn't aware of. You know, that's cool. I mean, you talk about, you know, rolling wheels if it happens, Weedsport. You know, I feel like your perspective is as good as anybody's. It seems like dirt racing in our area is healthier than it's been in a while.
Yeah, it is.
And I know there's still a level that we can keep going to, but as far as the last 5-10 years go, it seems like we've got more momentum than we've had in a while.
Yeah, I think, you know, when Glenn sold the, you know, dirt to Boundless, you know, I still remember the first meeting they had with us, you know, they called us, you know, Lead 11 or whatever it was they called us at that time.
Oh, yeah.
And we had that meeting in Syracuse, and they said to us, you know, this isn't going to be an evolution, it's going to be a revolution. And we all sort of looked at each other. At that time, you know, things were going really well. I mean, there was corporate sponsorship, you know, at that time they're paying pretty good, and you know, they're still paying what they're paying now, what they paid then, you know. So and the costs weren't nearly as much as they are now. So you know, and I think it really, the way they went about it was all wrong at that time, and it lost a lot of trust, yeah. And it took a lot of long time for get that trust back, and I think they finally have. I think Dirt Car has done a good job of finally getting back to, you know, making it so they're reliable. You know, they're going to be, you know, they have rules. They're going to go by the rules. You know, they're not going to mess around. They don't play favorites, you know, stuff like that, and try to make it so, you know, we know when we go to a track that we're going to put a show on, and we're not going to really have to worry about, you know, all this BS and stuff. We're just going to go race. Yeah. And that's all, as a racer, you want. You don't want to have to deal with stuff, you know, worry about, you know, favoritism or like that. And if even if the guy is an inept that's running the thing, you know, these guys pretty much know what they're doing now. And you know, it's slowly come back, and hopefully the next step is going to be, you know, get the pay up on some of this stuff. And, you know, people want to change rules. Well, you change the rules, you're going to cost money to the racer. You know, let's keep the rules sort of where they are. Maybe a few small rule changes, but nothing big. But, you know, they need to get sponsorship back in here and, you know, package it so it trickles down to the racer and, you know, gets in our pocket so we can spend money to get back to the racetrack.
Yeah. You were one of the guys that you know, spoke up about, you know, the positive things that Joe Scott Nicky brought to the team as far as World Racing Group goes. Now they transition into Mike Parati filling Scott Nicky's role. What is, for guys that you've talked to in the racing circles, he's had a few races down at Volusia, yep. But also with past experience, knowing Mike, where do you think, you know, is that? I mean, from guys we talk to, people feel like it's a good thing.
Yeah.
But what can you tell us about your experience with Mike?
Well, I've known Mike for a while. Actually, he tried running some of the series last year, but the Super Dirt series, but he'd been away from it. So, you know, he did struggle a little bit. And so I talked to him a few times. I've known him for a while. And personally, I don't, you know, when Joe left, I was trying to think, man, who the heck can they get? And I was praying they weren't going to bring somebody in that didn't really know the Northeast dirt modified scene and, you know, racing in general in the Northeast, because it's different than it is the rest of the country. It's a whole different deal. And I don't think they could have brought in a better guy than Mike. You know, he's run a track. He's raced the division.
Yeah.
You know, he knows pretty much everybody in the division. You know,
promoted, you know.
Yeah, he's done it all. So I think they've done a great job of hiring the right guy to do it. And hopefully they let him do his job the way he sees fit. You know, not trying to make him a puppet. Because I think, you know, if you look at Airborne Speedway where he promoted, you know, he really built that place up and made it a success. And really, you look at the area, and there's not a whole lot in that area. And, you know, and he brought it to life, and he made it relevant. And hopefully, you know, I talked to Matt and Justin a little bit tonight about that and how things went. And, you know, they were pretty happy with the way things went. And, you know, like I said, he just got his feet wet. But I think, like I said, if they let him do things the way that I think he wants it to be done, I think things will be good.
Well, I couldn't agree with you more there. I think that's a positive hire for them, and like you said, that's the key is letting the man do the job he's hired for. So.
Yep.
Well, man, it's good to catch up, man. Yep. It's good to talk racing here, and you know, looking forward to seeing you out at the Canandaigua opener. And I mean, is that where what we're looking at for this year is Canandaigua? And
well. I mean, I'd love to run a series, but right now I don't know what's going to go on there. If I could do Canandaigua, and then, you know, if Rolling Wheels is going to do what they're going to do, I'd love to run there and then run as much of the series as I can. You know, I don't know how much traveling I'll do. I'm going to drive for Tom Corr this year. I actually drove for him a little bit last year. He has a few cars. You know, Brent Wilcox won the championship for him at Thunder Mountain, and Brian Malcolm drives for him too, so... they're going to pick up their new car for me to drive here in a couple weeks from Bicknell's and throw it together. And we still haven't really got a schedule to go yet, but it's going to be a bunch of specials down in that area. It's going to have a small block in it. We ran a few races for them last year, and actually we had some good runs, just bad luck type deal, you
sure.
know. So look forward to running with them guys. I had a lot of fun last year, and hopefully we can have success there too.
Well, hopefully all the bad luck's in the rearview mirror. I think 2014 probably got your fill on that. So.
Yeah, definitely. It's it's racing. It is what it is. It makes you humble.
Yeah.
You know? So
sure.
But I'm back at it. Hopefully we can get things straightened out and get to the racetrack.
All right, that's Gary Tompkins, driver of the 84 Big Block Modified. Looking forward to seeing him out here at Canandaigua and Rolling Wheels. And thank you for your time, man. Always good to catch up with you.
Yep, thanks for having me.
For 17 years, Stock Car Steel has been a leading material supplier to the racing industry. Now they're also an official motorsports content partner of Race Chaser Online. The biggest names in NASCAR trust Stock Car Steel for all their raw materials, such as carbon steel, chrome moly, DOM, aluminum, plastics, and much, much more. You can't build a race car without the basic materials, and Stock Car Steel is the place to get them. Don't forget to also visit Stock Car Steel's sister company, SRI Supplies, for racing and industry. SRI is your number one source for all your shop supply needs. Nuts, bolts, rivets, tapes, adhesives, cutting tools, chemicals, body shop supplies, paint shop supplies, lubricants, and more. A well-stocked race shop is a winning race shop, and the road to winning begins with three letters, SRI. For more information, visit StockCarSteel.com and SRI-Supplies.com. You can also find them on Facebook at Stock Car Steel and Aluminum, or call either company toll-free at 1-888-752-7272.
Creekside Entertainment is the official DJ, photo booth, and uplighting company of Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network. Stuart Ovens and his staff at Creekside Entertainment are professional and experienced with events of any type. Creekside Entertainment specializes in wedding packages that are affordable and fun, and they are ready to serve you with the most up-to-date music and karaoke selection. If you can sing it in the shower, you can come out and sing it with Creekside Entertainment. And don't forget about the Creekside Entertainment photo booth and uplighting service that will transform your wedding or party into an event the family will be talking about for years. Trust the entertainment company that racers trust. Call Stu at area code 315-481-9700 or visit them online at creeksideentertainmentdj.com. You can also find them on Facebook and Twitter. Creekside Entertainment, division sponsor of the Black Rock Bandits in 2015.
We're growing like crazy and need account reps who know their way around agencies, the internet, and social media. Got connections? Or do you know how to get to the decision makers? Are you fearless? We need you. Internet radio, or as we call it, wireless mobile radio, is rapidly becoming the place to be with almost limitless income potential. So contact us to get involved with the fastest growing professionally produced group of internet radio stations in the world. Your imagination is the only limit here. Call 717-749-0444. That's 717-749-0444. Or you can email us at scorpionradiogroup@gmail.com. You want to ask for Sue.
Hi, race fans. This is Mills Family Racing, and you're listening to Turn 5 live on PMN.
Now we're going to get a chance to catch up with Sportsman Modified driver Ray Hendershot. Ray, been a while since I talked to you last, and good to see you here at the benefit, and been enjoying watching those pictures come up on social media, getting that car ready to go.
Yeah, we're trying to get ready for the Motor Sports Expo at the Syracuse Center Progress Building, basically for my sponsors. Due to the fact that last year I was kind of down and out and didn't really have a chance to promote the car.
Sure.
I feel a lot better this year.
Yeah.
We're winning the war with the cancer.
That's awesome.
And so now it's all about the sponsors this year.
I know that you spent some time down in New York City getting the treatments and Rochester, I believe, as well, right?
Yeah, we were in New York City, Memorial Sloan Kettering, for four treatments.
Okay.
Which was under the experimental drug therapy. The FDA approved it.
Okay.
Strong Memorial opened up a clinic while it was still the clinical drug, and I was able to transfer back to Rochester.
That's right.
When I transferred back to Rochester, then it was approved, so then we've been all set, and I've been doing my therapies at Strong.
Great. And, you know, glad to hear that you guys are making great progress on that. You know, we've been following along with you the last couple seasons, and going to be absolutely awesome to have you at the racetrack each week this year.
Well, I'm really looking forward to this year. Did a lot of changes with the car. I took my 08 Troyer and made it into a 15.
Okay.
And went out and bought a new rear end from Chad Phelps, you know, the new Smart Tube rear end. And
okay.
Got rid of the old lethargic 8-bolt. And
now you say Smart Tube rear end. Well, what is that?
It's got the polished aluminum ring and pinion, 411. It's real light.
Okay.
This one, we just got it in as a roller today, and it moves so much easier.
I was going to say, can you tell the difference
already?
Yeah,
very little force to move it compared to the old one where you really, two or three guys had to push it.
Yeah.
Now probably a 5 or 6-year-old could push it.
That's amazing that you can see that difference, and you haven't even been out on the racetrack yet.
Yeah, and, you know, talking with Nick and Kevin and the guys, you know, it's going to have a lot more quicker response from acceleration, deceleration, and I'm really looking forward to it. I want to get that bad boy up on the dirt and start doing some slinging. Too much working on it. I want to race it now.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You know, that is the cool thing about this group of guys here. You know, they've really taken you under their wing. You had dirt track experience years ago, and you know, so much has changed with even the track, the cars, you name it. So to have a group like this, you know, kind of help you along, I mean, that's got to be just, that's the best thing right there, you know?
Yeah, I couldn't ask for a better bunch of guys. I got to honestly say that the tango that me and Kevin had there in turn one was really emotional breakdown for me. It really upset me, and people who know me know that I'm very sensitive to that stuff, but you know, Kevin was a great sport about it, and but they've taken me under their wing, and they've really helped me a lot, and I really got to appreciate the Grearys for everything that they've done for me. So
yeah,
I can't ask for a better bunch of guys.
So I've asked a lot of the guys I've talked to tonight, you know, in their individual situations, what is going to make 2015 a successful season? I'll pose the same question to you.
Well, my goal last year was to crack the top 20 at Canandaigua, which I did. And with very limited, I only qualified for 11 races.
Okay.
And I missed 4 races due to treatment at in New York City and Strong, and 3 races I didn't qualify. So I feel very good that I was able to crack the top 20 with only just 11 races.
Sure.
This year the goal is to crack the top 15, and we want to run about 30 to 35 races.
Oh, wow.
I have committed to the Alliance schedule, and I'm trying to do the Grit North schedule too.
Okay.
But I got to balance it because my oldest daughter, Tara, is getting married in September.
Gotcha.
So I've already been forewarned that when September comes, you know, there's going to be priorities.
Well, we're getting married in October, and I know exactly what you're talking about.
You do. And the sad thing about it is there's a race on the 9th, September 19th, the day of my daughter's wedding. So I'm going to be thinking about the races while I'm walking her down the aisle.
Sure.
So
that's awesome.
But that's I want a nice, happy, you know, very good, successful season.
Yeah.
Stay out of trouble. Just go out and have fun. That's all I am. I'm just out to have fun.
With all of the different options that the sportsman guys have to run, you've got USA, you've got Grit, not to mention all the weekly tracks. It is such a great time to be a part of the Sportsman Modifieds right now, especially the crate engine.
Yeah, and it is. And the luxury about the Alliance is that, you know, where I live, I'm only, other than Utica Rome, all the other tracks are within 45 minutes.
Okay.
So it's very hop, skip, and a jump for me. You know,
sure.
Rolling Wheels is 30 minutes, Weed Sports 25 minutes, Canandaigua was 45 minutes, Brewerton is probably about 45, 50 minutes, and the longest run is going to be Utica Rome. But
cool.
I'm looking to, you know, do some traveling, even if, you know, I like to hit Fonda maybe once or twice, and I got some Larry and Mike Hendershot who run the Albany Saratoga circuit out there, and they run the open sportsman. I like to go out there once or twice to meet them guys.
Sure. Is there any of these tracks that you're looking forward to going back to that you haven't been to since way, you know, when
since
you ran
the 70s?
Yeah.
I've never raced on Fulton.
Okay.
And I've never raced on Brewerton or Utica Road.
Okay.
So I'm looking for it. I've been to Fulton and I've been to Brewerton with the modified when Johnny McCardo and Podolik and Dick Gamblin and all of them drove, but I've never driven on them, and I'm looking forward to that.
What do you think that moment's going to be like, you know, at either of those places when you roll out there and say, I'm out here doing this, man? You know, what do you think's going to be going through your head?
The only thing that really goes to my mind when I get on a track is to study the track, especially during the hot lap sessions.
Yeah.
And the goal for me this year is to never lift off the pedal and use the brake.
Okay.
So that's my goal this year. And
because with these crate engines, it's all about momentum.
It's all about momentum. And one thing I got going, buying the new rear end from Chad Phelps, it's a lot freewheeling. And I feel that we're going to be so much. I'm going to be behind the eight ball. I got a 3-year-old motor. But everything else in the car is relatively going to be brand new, except for the motor and the steering. Everything else is brand new because I'm trying to get it all ready for the Motorsports Expo. But
yeah,
I'm looking forward. I'm looking forward. I'm going down to Skyline.
Oh, okay.
I'm going down to Skyline in July when Canandaigua is off.
Yeah.
That's one track that I haven't been back to because I drove that once or twice in the modified.
Okay.
And so, and that's a little bull ring, you know. And so I'm looking forward to go back down there with the sportsman.
You talked about the engine. I mean, with these 602 crates, what's the shelf life on an engine like that?
You know, I really don't know. You know, this will be my third year, and this motor's going to be 3 years old. Crate motor connection, you know, where everybody's getting their motors, you know, is got a really nice package deal. You know, they break them in, they dyno them. They put their carburetor on, their ignition systems.
Yeah.
And it's basically dropping and ready to go. So I know Gibbs's motor's 3 or 4 years old,
yeah.
And mine's going to be 3 or 4 years old. So him and I are going to be behind the eight ball a little bit. But I just got done talking with Gibbs, and I says, you know, we're going to show them old them guys that got these this new equipment. We're going to show them a thing or two.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
I'm looking forward to it.
Well, they're going to have an adjustment period to, you know, a couple of guys that got brand new cars, and a couple guys have cars that may not be 2015s, but they're new to them. So,
right,
you know,
right.
you guys are going to be right there with them because there's going to be an adjustment period for sure.
Yeah, and it's hopefully the weather's going to help us, right?
Yeah,
I mean there's a ton of snow out there. And,
yeah,
you know, and cabin fever. I'm really looking forward to that.
Yeah.
And I got a strong feeling that's probably going to be our first race.
Cool.
I don't think April 4th we'll be able to touch that.
Yeah.
April 4th is what, about 4 weeks away?
Yeah.
And, you know,
it's going to be tough.
It's going to be real tough. And even March 11th is going to be tough, or April 11th.
And just, you know, nothing that anybody can do anything about, but Canandaigua is one of those places that when the grounds get wet, it takes a little bit for it to dry out. So this weather sticking around like it has, you know, none of that's going to help. But
yeah, so much for global warming, right?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Well, man, good to talk to you.
It's good talking to you,
Great to see you here,
well,
see that
you're
doing well. It's been a while since we had a chance to catch up with you. And before you go, I want to give you a chance to talk about all the great people behind you this year.
Well, we have Jerry Saunders Motorsports out of Syracuse is back with us. Balloons Restaurant out of Auburn, one of the best steakhouses in the whole area. Nicoletta Builder Contractors out of Clyde, T's and Moore's out of Clyde, Maximum Fitness out of Seneca Falls, and Mead Automotive Machine out of Clyde, who used to, Rick Mead's dad, Skip, or his brother Skip and Clint, used to have modifieds back many years ago. And again, we're carrying the banner with the American Cancer Society for the Relay for Life.
Awesome, awesome. Yeah. It's always good to see that on the car, and I imagine that you guys will have it on display like you have in the past.
Yes, we will.
So that's great.
Yep, we will be attending, maybe missing a couple shows. I may be scheduled for a couple Relay for Life events as the General Marshall. That's still in the works, but
okay.
Nothing conclusive yet. But we will display the American Cancer Society banner.
Good deal. Well, good luck getting the car ready.
Thank you.
Hopefully we'll see you up there at the Motorsports Expo show.
Yes, and, we will be there.
We'll look forward to seeing you out on the track. Hopefully soon we get this weather out of here.
Me too. Thank you.
All right. That's Ray Hendershot. He drives the 11J?
11B.
11B. That's right. He'll be out at Canandaigua Motorsports Park and a lot of different tracks this season that we haven't seen him at in the past. We'll have more from more dirt track drivers here on Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network.
How would you like to win a brand new Corvette? Larry O's got all the details.
WinYourNewCar.com. Enter America's number one dream car giveaway contest at WinYourNewCar.com. Complete the puzzle the fastest and win a new Corvette tax-free. Come on. Stop dreaming. Start driving with WinYourNewCar.com.
You hear that? That's the sound of America's only sports car. That's right. It's a Corvette. But not just any Corvette. It's your Corvette. It's that who cares if there's traffic part of your day. And this can be you when you come to Cooper Corvettes. With 60 years of Corvettes to choose from, there's always a Corvette in your budget. And they'll service any Corvette you bring in. Cooper Corvettes on Route 1 just north of Quantico and Triangle. Call, click, or visit CooperCorvettes.com.
Hi, this is Yen Scott from Summit Point Kart in Summit Point, West Virginia. If you're looking for a real racing experience on a real racetrack, come out to Summit Point Kart this weekend. For as little as $25, you can get your racing career started. New this year, Summit Point Kart offers the RX250 capable of over 75 miles an hour. We're open every Friday from 5 p.m. till 9 p.m., Saturday from noon till 10 p.m., and Sunday from noon till 9 p.m. For more information, go to our website, summitpointkartwithak.com, or you can call us at 304-725-5270. Summit Point Kart, your East Coast karting center.
In the race of everyday life, it's nice to have the green flag, but drivetrain problems are the pits. A fully remanufactured engine, transmission, or differential from Jasper Engines and Transmissions costs less than a new vehicle and comes with a 3-year, 100,000-mile nationwide transferable warranty. See jasperengines.com for details and get the green flag in your race of everyday life.
See the boys at Chandler & Sons Automotive, 45977 Old Ox Road in Sterling. Give them a call, 703-437-7300.
If you're a gearhead, you probably go online to those hot rod superstores, drooling over the chrome and speed goodies until you find just the right item for your muscle car, tuner car, truck. But what do you do when it comes to fixing the mom mobile? If you're like most do-it-yourselfers, you head to the strip mall parts store and talk to the "Do you want fries with that?" kid behind the counter. Hold on, Bunky! Did you stop to think where those chain stores are getting the parts that you're installing in the vehicle that's used to transport your family everywhere? They get the cheapest suppliers they can find to sell you the parts at bargain prices. Their limited lifetime warranties? What a joke! Remember the last time mom's car broke down? You heard about that one for weeks. Don't take that chance again. Excelsior Racing has the quality parts you need for your family vehicle. Parts that you can install knowing you're getting the best for your family. Excelsior Racing. Quality parts. Personalized service. Affordable pricing. Fast to you direct. Excelsior Racing. Online at ExcelsiorRacing.com or call 502-909-2034.
Hi, race fans. This is Jeremy Trank, and now back to Stephen Clinton Brand.
Welcome back, race fans, to Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Clint Miller, Brad Ovens, Steve Ovens joining you here on a Tuesday night talking dirt track racing. And now we're going to talk 305 sprint cars with none other than Darrell Ruggles, 2014 Yates County Speedway Track Champion, 2014 Canandaigua Motorsports Park Champion. Darrell, welcome to the show. Good to have you for the first time here on our live show.
Thank you, and I'm glad to do it.
Well, man, let's talk about it. You had a stellar year in 2014, picking up championships at Yates County and Canandaigua. You guys are really getting a good handle on this sprint car deal.
Yeah, it was. We were really good with the micro sprints, and then when we moved into this class, I was really unsure on how things were going to go, and then we just started to good right out of the box, you know, 2 years ago. You know, there was some really good competition at Canandaigua, and we picked it up rather fast, and, you know, I transferred a lot of the micro sprint technology to the big car, and then I've had a lot of help with, you know, Mike Maston built really good motors, You know, Mike Emhoff, he pointed me in the right direction for some really good cars, you know, and I just had a lot of people, you know, that gave me a lot of good input, which, you know, we put it to use early, and, you know, it just worked out, and it just made it perfect.
Talk to us about trying to get a handle on both Yates County, Dundee, now going to be named Blackrock, and Canandaigua, because, you know, they are two different racetracks to work with there.
Well, Canandaigua, you know, the place generally gets real black, super slick, you know, all the time. But the one sideball that they always throw to you is they mix the classes up so you're not running the same rotation every Saturday night. You know, one night you'll run first features, one night you'll run the last features. So you always have different track conditions, so you just got to kind of keep an eye on the track conditions, you know, to make sure that you're prepared with the tires and, you know, your wing angles and all that stuff. It's just a learning thing that we've learned, and, you know, we've taken notes on the nights that we did really well and, you know, studied what the track was doing and tried to keep up on it. But all the years of racing big block at Canandaigua and all the years I raced, you know, in Sportsman and stuff at Canandaigua, you know, the place feels comfortable to me. So, you know, we found something that really worked good with the black slick, you know, and I think the micro sprint technology, you know, that we've learned through the years with the micro sprint was very beneficial with the big sprint cars, you know, with all the input from a lot of great people that, you know, have helped us along the way. But Canandaigua, and then when you go to Blackrock, which is a lot tackier, you know, Dan Harpel and his kids did an excellent job this year with that track. You know, the thing had great bite all night long, but again, it's totally opposite of Canandaigua. Canandaigua's dry slick. That place is kind of rough, you know, tacky, really bitey, and so we had to change. It took a couple of weeks to figure that out, and we finally figured, you know, a setup out that worked good for that. Pretty much just a shock change, a little bit different with the wing, and then we run a little bit different stagger with the cars at that place. But relatively, the baseline setups on the cars are, you know, you can go to the racetrack with the same setup. You just, all the stuff that's adjustable week in, week out with tires and stagger and wing adjustments, that's where we made our changes, and, you know, we made the difference there.
Now, coming up, obviously, 2014 was just a year for the record books. Coming up to 2015, I know we were talking at the Yates County banquet. You had some plans to still run the 305, but you also had some bigger plans to get out and do some more traveling.
Well, the bigger plans is we picked up a deal of a lifetime with Danny Wilmus. I'll be driving his 360 car, and about 2 months ago he purchased a 360 car for my daughter, so that, I mean, I would never, ever be able to do that without Danny. So that we've been preparing two brand new cars for 360 for Danny Wilmus to, you know, to race in the 360 deal this summer. You know, I don't know what shows, you know, we haven't gone through the schedule and stuff yet, but we'll get through that before the car show and stuff's over. But he's given us an opportunity of a lifetime to race 360 for him. Me and my daughter, and then we're still going to run the Canandaigua, you know, the 305. So we've definitely got a lot on our plate for this summer, you know, with a lot of other people helping us. But, I mean, Danny gave us, you know, two stellar cars, and hopefully we can do really, really well with those. I know it's going to be difficult for my daughter. You know, she's never raced big blocks, so she hasn't had horsepower like that, but I hope it works out for her. I hope she just learns. You know, Danny's prepared that it's a learning year for her. It's definitely going to be a learning year for me. But we ran four races last year, and one race didn't turn out so good. But, you know, if we didn't get in a wreck, we probably would have had a really good top three, top four finish. You know, we started 16th, you know, in the 360. And so, you know, I'm excited. Danny's excited, and, you know, everybody that works on the car is pretty excited.
As they should be. And you know, talking about being excited, Daryl, I know you guys have your annual benefit coming up, and I wanted to give you guys a chance to talk about that.
Yeah, we have a benefit party, which, I mean, when it's, you know, we pretty much put, you know, I own all my 305 stuff. Danny owns all the 360 stuff. So this year it's definitely going to be pretty expensive season, that's for sure. But what we do is it's just a benefit party that gives us a little bit extra money to get through the season or to get started. How we started this years ago when, you know, we didn't have any sponsors, you know, to help us along the way. We used to have a party and full buffet dinner, and we used to have a DJ, and, you know, people come, and we did door prizes and raffles, and it just seems like every year we do it because we have so much fun and we see so many people, you know, our fans and our sponsors and our followers and just people that just want to support racing come. And last year we ended up having a band. We had a band come, and a slow rider band, and we had it at the Shortsville American Legion, where it is this year. It's going to be on March 21st at the Shortsville American Legion. Starts at 5 o'clock, and we'll do dinner and raffles and all that stuff. And after like 8 or 8:30, the band Slow Riders plays. And last year we had more people than I can possibly imagine. We had like 250 to 270 people attend the party, and it was just a really good time. Gave us a pretty big boost, you know, to get started with the season, with expenses and stuff. And we're going to do the same thing again this year. And if I can have 200 people again this year, that would be awesome. But you can't expect that. But we always do. We cook enough food for 250, 300 people. My wife, my sister Debbie, and her mom, Wendy's mom, Linda, and Brian, and his father, Pops, they do a ton of the food. You know, they do it all themselves. And I don't know what they've got on the menu for this year, but I'm sure it'll be good like it always is.
Absolutely. Something else that's unique that you guys do that I think is pretty cool is I wanted to ask if you guys are still going to be doing the sign your name on the checkered flag for sponsors this year up at the car show.
Yep, we are. Our cars this year are going to be they're going to be pretty unique. They're different. They're almost done. Wendy's just finishing up with some of the vinyl. My wife's doing all the vinyl this year. And with four cars, we weren't, you know, normally we always paint the checkers on the cars. This year, Wendy come up with a design for the checkers that are on the car that we can still sign the checkers, and we're going to do the same thing at the car show at which is March 14th and 15th at the Motorsports Expo. And, you know, we've had people already call us up and buy them, you know, say, hey, I want to reserve a checker. And it's just a way for people to, you know, for $5. And, you know, some people give us more than that. But, I mean, we don't ask for that. And then after the races are over, they come back to the pits and they look for their name, you know, to make sure their name's on the car. This year will definitely be difficult trying to keep up with it with four cars with, you know, two 360s and then two 305 cars. But Wendy and Alicia and the girls, they'll keep the names on there. And, you know, it's very cool because we see people come back every year to get their checkers, you know. And it's pretty awesome to be able to say that you have 400, you know, checker sponsors, you know. And, you know, some of them spend more than $5, which that's what helps, because you know, and everybody else in this world knows that without sponsorship, it's almost impossible to do this. And you can't do it without sponsors, and you can't do it without good people.
Well, you talk about those sponsors, Daryl, and I want to give you an opportunity to talk about all the great folks working with you guys.
Well, Danny Wilmus, obviously, for this year with the 360 deal. And you know, Mike Emhoff, he's been a huge, huge supporter of us. And, you know, all this stuff is it can't be possible without good motors. Mike Maston and Andy, that's where I'm at tonight. I'm at the shop working on my new 305. Last year at Dundee there, I broke that motor. And we just finally got all the pieces from Eagle. They finally sent all the parts that we needed to finish up the motor. You know, and Danny got me a new block for this, for the 305, And I'm just working on doing all the work to the block. And, you know, Mike, he'll be working on it here soon. So we're preparing the 305 for Canandaigua for this year, which will be a new motor. And then Tim Engler, he does all the injection systems. And he has right now, he has Alicia's 360 out there and her 305 out there. He's running them on his dyno doing a little research and development. And he picked up a little bit of horsepower and a little bit of torque on her 305 motor compared to what she had last year. So, you know, Tim Engler, you know, with Mike Maston, it's a great combination between the motors. Mike Van Bordel, Van Bordel Trucking, you know, Fox's Auto, they send me a ton of body shop work, and he helps us out on the cars all the time. He's a great supporter of it. FK Rod Ends, and... because they help my daughter out with the sprint car girls, and, you know, they take care of all the high men's. And Ingles Performance out of Phoenix, they're a snowmobile Polaris dealer. They give us a side-by-side razor to push start one of the cars because we have two cars. So we bought one of them, and then they ended up giving us one for a demo. So Ingles Performance, and there's just so many people, you know, that sponsor with the checkers and stuff like that. But, you know, between Mike Maston, Mike Emhoff, and Danny Wilmus, you know, and Engler and Foxes and Van Bordel Trucking, I can't do it without those guys.
Well, Daryl, that's a great crew to have on your side. Looking forward to seeing you guys up at Motorsports Expo and out at the benefit party. And, boy, just can't wait to get this race season started. So we'll see you and Alicia both out at the races here real soon.
Yeah, that'll be cool. Thank you for having me on the show. And, you know, if anybody is listening to the show and they're looking to, you know, have a good time on March 21st, our benefit party starts at 5, you know, and it goes most of the night. And it's a really good band. It's a country rock band. And it's a great food. My wife and my sister and, you know, everybody puts on. It's a great meal, you know, and I just can't thank all the guys that work on my car enough.
All right, Daryl, that's Daryl Ruggles calling in, driver of the 48 Junior 305 Sprinter as well as the 360. You'll see him out on the circuit and at Canandaigua this year. Right straight ahead, we've got more dirt track discussion with the three of us here, the three stooges of dirt track racing. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network.
You hear that? That's the sound of America's only sports car. That's right, it's a Corvette. But not just any Corvette, it's your Corvette. It's that who cares if there's traffic part of your day. And this can be you when you come to Cooper Corvettes. With 60 years of Corvettes to choose from, there's always a Corvette in your budget. And they'll service any Corvette you bring in. Cooper Corvettes on Route 1 just north of Quantico and Triangle. Call, click, or visit CooperCorvettes.com.
Hi, this is Yen Scott from Summit Point Kart in Summit Point, West Virginia. If you're looking for a real racing experience on a real racetrack, come out to Summit Point Kart this weekend. For as little as $25, you can get your racing career started. New this year, Summit Point Kart offers the RX250 capable of over 75 miles an hour. We're open every Friday from 5 p.m. till 9 p.m., Saturday from noon till 10 p.m., and Sunday from noon till 9 p.m. For more information, go to our website, summitpointkartwithak.com, or you can call us at 304-725-5270. Summit Point Kart, your East Coast Karting Center.
In the race of everyday life, it's nice to have the green flag, but drivetrain problems are the pits. A fully remanufactured engine, transmission, or differential from Jasper Engines and Transmissions costs less than a new vehicle and comes with a 3-year, 100,000-mile nationwide transferable warranty. See JasperEngines.com for details and get the green flag in your race of everyday life.
See the boys at Chandler & Sons Automotive, 45977 Old Ox Road in Sterling. Give them a call, 703-437-7300.
Creekside Entertainment is the official DJ, photo booth, and uplighting company of Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network. Stuart Ovens and his staff at Creekside Entertainment are professional and experienced with events of any type. Creekside Entertainment specializes in wedding packages that are affordable and fun, and they are ready to serve you with the most up-to-date music and karaoke selection. If you can sing it in the shower, you can come out and sing it with Creekside Entertainment. And don't forget about the Creekside Entertainment photo booth and uplighting service that will transform transform your wedding or party into an event the family will be talking about for years. Trust the entertainment company that racers trust. Call Stu at area code 315-481-9700 or visit them online at creeksideentertainmentdj.com. You can also find them on Facebook and Twitter. Creekside Entertainment, division sponsor of the Black Rock Bandits in 2015.
How would you like to win a brand new Corvette? Larry O's got all the details.
WinYourNewCar.com. Enter America's number one dream car giveaway contest. At WinYourNewCar.com, complete the puzzle the fastest and win a new Corvette tax-free. Come on, stop dreaming. Start driving with WinYourNewCar.com.
Hi, race fans. This is Kelly Hebing, and you're listening to Turn 5 Live on PMN.
And, you know, we're also going to get a chance here to talk to Kelly Hebing. She's going to grab a chair here and the microphone, and we'll see what Kelly has on tap for 2015. I got to tell you, I think it's starting to become, you know, we used to, obviously we knew Kelly, Chuck's daughter, driving the sprint car, turning heads, gaining every race she goes to. I got to tell you now, we probably know you just as much for graphic design as we do with the race car. You guys are doing some pretty impressive things over there.
It's been cool to figure out how my race car gets made.
There you go. Sorry about that.
It's all right. It's been cool to see and work with Dan Pilot over there. We used to just drop off the cars and you leave and come back a couple days later and your car's all finished and looks good and everything, so... It was different getting to see it from start to finish, but it's been a blast over there, and it's been cool to really see how much goes into getting all these cars done, not just mine, just all the modifieds and sportsmen's we've done and everything.
So talk to me about this time of year.
It's got to
be
crazy.
Nuts. I mean, how all these beautiful cars here, I'm sure a lot of which you've probably seen come through the shop. I can't imagine how crazy it's got to be this time of season for you guys.
The end result makes it look really cool going through the show and knowing you had a part of these, but Dan's got a lot on his plate and he handles it every day.
Yeah.
And I don't know how he keeps it straight, but at the end of the week we get through it and it's been crazy. This and Super Dirt Week is one of the busiest times for him.
Sure.
And throughout the week we've had 20 modified bodies stacked against our walls and 4 sprint cars lined up down the center of the shop.
Well, I'll tell you what, you guys do some fantastic work because the race cars we're seeing out here in Syracuse look absolutely awesome. Let's talk about the sprint car. We got it on display down there. Looks awesome, and as I understand, you guys have got the asphalt set up on there.
We do. We talked with Evans Mills, and we're really trying to promote that race for them, the ESS Asphalt Assault. And this year, it's in memory of Kevin because he enjoyed that. And last year was my first race when I participated in it, and it's just one of those fun races. Yeah. I got to race side by side with guys who've been in sprint cars for 10 years and stuff, and I'm competitive with them. And it was just one of those races where it's a no holds, have fun.
Yeah.
No stress. You get 2 hot lap sessions before your heat. And it was just a night where you got to have fun.
Yeah.
And there was nothing to worry about. So it's cool. And we knew we were going to be near the ESS booth and we wanted to do something different. And Dad took it way beyond what I thought we were going to come here with. I joke with everybody who says they like the display. And I said, yeah, I asked for that show sign and this is what I got.
Well, you know, he puts a lot of hard work into it too, and some of the pieces that comes out of his shop are just incredible as well. As far as what you guys are looking at, are we looking at kind of a similar schedule that we've seen recently over the years? Or?
Similar, hopefully a little more myself staying home. I love to travel with Dad and watch Joey, but I'm having a little more fun doing it myself now.
Sure.
But for sure, the team and I got way used to the 305 and working together and working with what I want out of the car and stuff. So I didn't want to take away that we were finally having good runs and we were well enough off to have a win last season. I'd like to continue that a little bit more this season, then move up. I'd I didn't want to go up and then be in the way and still have to learn everything.
Sure. What was that like getting the first win? You know, kind of finally getting that monkey off your back.
It was cool. It made it more special to me, I guess, because the whole family and crew were there.
Yeah.
And it's just one of those things, like, you prove to yourself that you can do this, and with Dad being the Cobra, there's a lot to live up there. And it was cool to finally make a name like Kelly Hebing. She won one, too.
She, so. Yeah, that's awesome. I mean, yeah, because that's, you know, when you grow up as, you know, as offspring of somebody that has done so much in their career, I mean, you see it all the way from dirt to NASCAR. That's sometimes tough to try and, you know, you put all that pressure on yourself to live up to that.
At first it was, in my head, it was going to be hard because everybody knows the Cobra, everybody knows Chuck, and it was like my turn, so I have to go out there and prove it. And it wasn't like that. Dad's been my biggest supporter and my biggest coach, and he takes away the whole, well, I've done this, I've done that. That doesn't even get brought up. Him and Mom have been every step of my learning curve, and every race we pull into, he'll bring me right up to the track and say, well, this is where I run, try this. Or if you see a guy get by you, try his line and learn it. And it's just been a huge learning experience, and I'm not more thankful than to do it with those guys.
I know that coming back this year, SUNY Canton, I know they've been a great supporter of your racing efforts, and you got them back this year.
Yep, we got Canton back on, which is awesome. They help out Dean and ESS, and it was cool that Mike Perry still wanted to do stuff with me after graduating. And then L&J Landscaping is back on for this season. And then I bugged Stuart and Jessica to come on with 1ZTs.
There you go.
So they're on for the 2015 season also.
Good deal. And, you know, that's a newer company for them. And if you follow them, that 1ZTs on Facebook, they put out some really, really nice stuff.
They've doing a lot of stuff for a lot of people, and it's good work. And we got our crew shirts, and Dad got shop shirts from them so far.
Cool. Well, I'll tell you, it's always good to talk to you guys to see what's going on for the season. Talk to us about the other folks that are on with you. You got L&J Landscaping, SUNY Canton.
First and foremost, Danny Wilmus.
Yeah.
He's been my biggest backbone since I moved up in the 305. And this year he was helping us out even more, and he put some new smoke under our hood.
Nice.
So we're excited to try that out. And then we got Cooks coming back. And then Dad and Mom, really. And
yeah.
I steal Dad's crew guys on a nightly basis. And we got them working on two cars instead of one. So those guys are what makes the team. And Joey comes out, and it's cool to have that kind of relationship that we don't need to go to the movies and stuff. He can come to work on my race car.
That's what I'm talking about, you know? When it's date night and you can say, hey, let's go to the races. Man, that's the best.
It's funny because our friends ask you, what are you doing? Well, we're going to the racetrack.
Yeah.
You guys can go to your movies and your dinners on a Friday night if we're not racing. We're at Spencer Speedway supporting our friends. So it's fun because our whole families grew up with it, and then we grew up together. So it's been cool to keep doing it together.
Absolutely. Well, first race, did you guys have a target of
the Canandaigua opener, I guess, is what it'd be for me.
It's okay.
Late April, I guess. Hopefully the weather works with us.
You know, I'll tell you, if it keeps going the way it's been going this week, I think we're going to be okay. But, you know, that's a lot of hoping.
Yeah.
Well, that's Kelly Hebing. She drives a SUNY Canton 10 305 sprint car. You can see her out at Canandaigua, and looking forward to seeing her progress in 2015. And I don't think I'm going out on a limb here and saying I really feel like that Canandaigua win is coming this season.
You had some
excellent runs out there. So I don't think that's too far-fetched here in the near future. Well,
thank you, race fans, for tuning in to the best of Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. You can catch us every Tuesday night at 7:30 p.m. right here at PerformanceMotorsportsNetwork.com. Thank you and good night.
Turn 5 Live is a copyrighted production of the Performance Motorsports Network. PerformanceMotorsportsNetwork.com is a member of the Scorpion Radio Group, Incorporated, and may not be rebroadcast, replicated, or saved in any media without the explicit written permission of PMN. The opinions expressed on this program are those of the host, co-host, and guest, and do not necessarily reflect those of the management and ownership of either the Performance Motorsports Network or Scorpion Radio Group, Incorporated, the advertisers, or marketing partners. Thank you for listening to Turn 5 Live. You can listen to Turn 5 Live every Tuesday night right here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Stay tuned for more great PMN programming. Just searching for a world with your soul. This is free.